there, welcome to Stuck in Beta. I am Greg, and with me is Josh, and also Josh.
I'm also Josh.
Oh. Hey, I'm having some crazy internet speeds today. This is awful. I'm getting 4.3 megabits down. That's horrible.
That's bad.
That's really bad.
Can you see us okay, Mike?
Maybe you're... Oh, there is Mike.
Damn, look at that.
Maybe you need some cable lube. That'll help the bits move faster.
I think that's just for getting it through ceilings and stuff.
Hmm.
Yeah. Huh. I don't know if you knew that or not. Well, hey, we got a great show for you today.
Not a really long show. We're going to have to be fast if we're getting through this agenda.
Where do you want to start? I mean, do you guys do any... We'll start with our normal. Do you do anything you want to talk about from the weekend?
I cut down on... Oh, first of all, as in a continuance from last week.
Oh. Do you need to really drink it out of the can?
I'll drink it out of the can.
Oh, wow.
I'm drinking my water.
Yeah, that was the best show, hands down.
I agree.
I watched it from start to finish with my wife, and she cracked up at a lot of it. She kept, and she would like talk back to our conversations too. It was funny. It was really good.
I'm sure.
Too
Michael,
bad this week.
Michael chime in on the chat room because I chatted with him. What did he say?
He said it cut out, but now you're back.
Oh, okay. I had an $1,100 tree cut down in my backyard this week.
Only $1,100.
Oh, I got them. The bid started at $2,400. Got them down to $1,100.
Really?
I read a book, The Art of the Deal, and we built.
Now you read that in between,
yeah,
or you...
Yeah, it was just a day and a half. A quick read. Yeah.
By Donald Trump.
Yeah, it's a great book. I'm building a big wall out of the wood. No, it, so
someone can't hear. Are you? You still can't hear?
Looks like we're buffering.
Huh. Well, no, I stopped it on mine.
Josh is buffering too.
Yeah, I'm buffering.
Dang it, Greg! I can't help it, Charter. How's the hearing out there? Everyone hear us?
Mike.
Molly says can't hear.
Type a message to Mike.
Mike says
I
hear you.
He hear you.
Okay.
All right, I'm not saying Molly's wrong, but...
No, maybe she typed that before.
Okay.
But so I called like five people. Everybody said the tree needed to come down because it was in bad shape. Did you know the only living part of the tree is the outer layer, which is like an inch thick?
Yeah, the bark.
No, underneath the bark.
That's
what explains. I didn't realize the whole... I mean,
that's why there's rings.
Yeah, okay. I guess I'm an idiot.
Yeah.
So a good chunk of that outer layer was damaged on this tree, and that's why it was dying. So I had like five or six bids. Everybody was coming in around the same price, $2,400 to $2,700. And then I talked to a buddy of mine that's got one of those big outdoor fireplaces that runs his furnace. Like, he has those water pipes that goes in it, and he constantly is burning wood all winter long. And I said, hey, do you want this wood? And he said, yeah, I'll come get it. I got chainsaws. I'll cut it up. He said, you just get it put on the ground. Tell the guys you don't want them to clean up, and I'll come and clean up after him. He said, we'll do it.
Ah, sorry.
You know, professionalism. So that cut my bid down to $1,100. I paid cash. He said, I'll knock $100 off, so it was $1,100.
Wow.
Nice.
They got there at noon. The one guy spent 20 minutes manually sharpening the chainsaws. I mean, like, had a file and was manually...
Yeah.
You guys, these are professionals. They treat their equipment right. It was amazing. The other guy's throwing the rope up in the tree to get ready to climb it. From the time they started to the time I handed the guy the money and he got in the truck and left, was 3 hours flat.
Wow. And that's even with them sharpening.
So. Yeah.
Why didn't they have it sharpened before they got
there?
They
just came from another job.
Oh, okay.
But that, think about that. That's over $300 an hour.
Right. Wow.
But to watch them do that was absolutely amazing. It was unbelievable. I had this one limb that was like 30 feet long. It was hanging over the neighbor's fence by about 10 feet. And I was thinking, okay, they're going to cut this down. It's going to fall straight down. It's going to kill one of the dogs and one of my neighbor's dogs and take out part of the fence. He's like, oh, no, it won't do that. So they cut it and they do their thing. And he's like, watch this. And he cuts it the rest of the way. And he cut it real slow. And the way they notched it first, the limb swung around as it broke and then broke free and landed on the tree, the pile of brush.
Wow.
It was amazing.
There's art to it.
Yeah. Hmm.
I was trying to find but I couldn't find a video.
I saw you shared that little video with us, but
I've got
a
bunch
more
on Plus. Yeah, it was fantastic. So I got somebody coming Friday to, because the bottom trunk is probably 30 feet long. So he's going to cut that up, take all the brush away, and adios tree.
So you're not angry this week like you were last week?
I'm still in a funk. We got some stuff going on.
He's funky.
Let's
funky.
Can we jump right into that? You told us you wanted to drop off Facebook, and I really want to understand
That's less than half of my issue right now.
But what causes... I hear this all the time, and I see people... I'm not one that's on Facebook, like, at all. But every once in a while, somebody will say, I'm taking a break or whatever, and they'll drop off for a while. And I never understand why.
Blame the liberals.
Well, if you don't agree with people that are, politically or whatever, you could always hide there.
I've hidden my fair share of people.
You know.
Trust me.
Is that the reason why?
No,
because things just...
It's too much of a time consumer.
Yeah. Oh, so you've got a problem.
I've got a problem.
You're addicted. You know,
absolutely.
Gave it up for Lent. Was it last year?
Yeah.
Was it last year or the year before?
I did it. It might have been 2 years ago.
Yeah.
I remember you would just have Annette would be posting things for you or asking questions.
Yeah, because we were still doing the playground stuff at that time. Yeah.
Yeah, so it was kind of cheating, you know.
I was not on Facebook.
Well,
so you think you spend a lot of time just scrolling and stuff like that, and you're trying to cut that out. It's kind of a personal thing more than
the app's gone off my phone now.
Oh, okay. But so why were you saying that it's so you're afraid you can't use Messenger or
I can. I just I would just get rid of all of it.
I don't ever look at Facebook, like, very, very rarely.
Apparently I have an addictive personality.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Hence the Truly water.
The Truly's making another appearance.
Yeah.
I need an intervention, apparently.
You know, I've got seven Jesus ways Christ. To cleanse yourself of
Here
negativity.
Let's hear it. I want to hear it.
The negativity didn't bother me.
Well, you know, number one, put the phone down. So you're probably already... starting that way by putting the phone down,
as being an IT, it's extremely hard to remove yourself from one of these devices.
Well, you're just gonna get on Twitter.
Instagram. I'll be on Instagram.
It'll just link to the same articles.
Like, it's like an alcoholic. As well as I do, your job smoker. Is tied to that device.
Yeah, I don't really use mine for work except for some notes. How about reading a book? You know, it'll clear the mind.
I don't like reading books.
You just talked about reading a book.
I was joking.
Oh.
Half the shit I say is not true, Josh. Come on.
That's smudging your home. Smudging or burning sage throughout
that's real new age and hippie life.
Yeah, you could really clear your mind.
The Native American.
Change the energy around you, you know.
Oh, I like number five.
Take a bath. Maybe that's all it is.
I am not a bath person. That's, sorry.
That's going to fix everything.
No, yeah.
No.
Light some candles, essential oils, one of those bath bombs, you know?
Not doing it.
You're ready to go.
You know a little too much about taking a bath.
Bombs? But I don't know.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Delete the unnecessary, you know?
Facebook.
Make yourself simplistic, you know?
Get outside. That's bullshit.
Well, you got rid of a tree. That was kind of...
Yeah, killing nature.
Get outside.
Killing the outside.
Get the fresh air outside. Hey, it's been nice outside.
When it's
spring,
I'll be on my boat. How's that?
Well, yeah. And breathe. Breathe is, you know, just...
You kind of got to do that.
Remember to breathe.
Who wrote this?
I don't know.
This is... exobenzo.com.
Martina Dorif.
Yeah, that was great, Greg.
Yeah, that's awesome. Great.
Well,
thanks for the content. Thanks for feeling my pain, you two.
Well, it's better than... Huh. Never mind.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Super Bowl. Or can we say Super Bowl?
Yeah, why not? Well, I mean, what are they going to do?
Yeah.
What are they going to sue us for all the money we're making?
Make? Yeah.
That's true. Super Bowl's coming up.
So, yeah. I was thinking about it the other day, and I'm like, man, I probably haven't watched an entire quarter. If you summed up all of the football I've watched this year, I probably haven't watched a quarter's worth of football.
I'm probably pretty close to you. I watched a few key games. I watched a couple of the
a couple minutes here and there?
With the NFC and AFC championship games I watched. That's about it.
I didn't watch any of them. I tuned in just to see that one when Green Bay won. Was it in the last few seconds.
Yeah.
And I saw those last few seconds.
Yeah.
But that's about it. And I couldn't really care less about who wins this game.
I could care less who wins. It's more of a social
event. Yeah.
I'm the same way. I haven't watched any. I mean, without a team, you know, that...
Oh, here we go. We're going to cry about the Rams.
I'm not going to say crying about the Rams, but I don't really have a team that I root for. We don't have a home team. They kind of left on bad terms. I'm not going to root for Kansas City.
Why?
The same way I won't root for the Royals.
Oh, it's two totally different things.
It's a city that I do not root for. I don't root for Chicago teams. I don't
Greg
root
hates
for
Kansas City. Kansas
Apparently,
City
don't go to Kansas City.
No,
Greg,
I don't hate
Kansas. Arrest you coming into
Actually,
city limits.
I enjoy Kansas City. It's a really
I hate your teams.
Yeah, exactly.
So I've taken a page out of your book, Greg, where you refused
to
watch.
You read my
watch.
Book?
I was the one.
I was wondering why there was a page missing.
You refuse to watch trailers and things like that whenever you're getting ready to go see a movie.
Yeah. Yeah.
If you know you're going to see...
if you know me...
I'm going to see Star Wars. It doesn't matter. So, apparently...
Hey, Jet, your brother's calling.
Oh, come on.
Should we put him on the air?
Yeah, let's do it. Hey, caller, you're on the air.
Oh, we lost him.
Aw.
Oh.
Here he is.
There he is.
Let's do it. Who is it?
Boss Jack Jr.
Oh.
Jeff, are you there?
Yes.
Hey, you're live on our podcast. How are you doing?
I am.
What's up, Jeff?
How are
first
you?
First caller. Welcome to the show.
We didn't even give the
your
number
first
out.
Caller.
Say. For long time listener, first time caller.
Wow, this is great.
What can we do for you?
This is great.
What can we do for you?
Well, I need to bring the dog. I'm calling to bring the dog by the house.
Oh, that's exciting.
The studio, Jeff, not the house, the studio.
Yeah.
The what?
All right. Well,
the studio. Oh yeah, the mega. How many? It's two stories, huh?
It. Come on now. This is a big fine studio. You know.
Beer
pub.
Yeah. Anyway,
yeah,
I'm assuming this
There's
is.
There's a beer cooler there. Yeah.
I'm assuming this is happening today.
Yes, this is happening today because. Tomorrow we're leaving for London.
Ooh.
Ooh.
So you excited? Ooh. You got it all planned out where you're going? Well, I'm
Yeah, we're going
London.
To well, we're going to you know we're going to London.
Well, okay, yes, then but you're going to other places in Europe.
Yes, we're also going to Rome,
You just hung up on him.
Did we hang up on
Did
you?
Did you hang up on him?
Aww.
You there? They did the red thing at the top.
Oh,
I wonder if we're having internet problems.
Well, we may have lost him.
Well, this will be our first caller and visitor to the show.
Wow.
Yeah.
No, we had...
No, O'Malley was in on site.
He's calling
back.
We had...
Dr. Seeger.
Hey, you still there?
Yeah, I'm still here.
We lost you. Well, hey, let me just...
Yeah, I know you lost me.
We'll see you in, like... When are you going to be over? I know this is personal stuff on the air, but when are you going to be...
Great show.
When are you going to be over? I will be over at your address, which is...
Okay, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I guess I'll be over there, and I guess I'm assuming about an hour.
Okay. Well, we'll be done with this by then.
Because, okay, yeah. I got to drop. Logan's going to the skating party tonight, so.
On a school night? Wow.
What's the rest of the family?
Wow, yeah.
Laugh the same.
So.
All right, we do not laugh the same.
They sneeze the same, too.
Yeah. All right, Jeff. Well, it's been nice talking to you, and thanks for calling. Call in again
call
sometime.
Call in again, yeah.
I called twice. Right. He had two callers.
And the line wasn't busy. That's amazing.
I know.
That's
the phone lines are lighting up here.
What did I win?
A beer.
Hey, what's the phrase that pays?
The phrase that pays?
Yeah. Come on.
I don't know. I can't remember that.
All right. Well, it's
Molly wants to know if, Jeff, are you eating with Molly and Greg?
Am I eating with Molly and Greg?
Why are we expanding?
No. What, okay. Well, what are we having for dinner?
We've got right. to get to.
All right, Jeff. We'll talk to you. We'll talk to you later.
Oh, God. Man.
All right.
Bye. I'll see you, man. Bye.
That's awesome.
Oh, that was funny.
Man, that's great. We need more callers. Okay, so what were we talking about?
I don't
Your
know.
Your hatred for Kansas City.
Yeah.
No, I was just saying trailers, you brought
up. Oh, yeah. No, yeah. I was. Every time I. The last week, they keep releasing the Super Bowl commercials, and I have avoided watching any of them. And
sorry, then I sent one the other day.
Oh, you did? I didn't even see it.
Didn't I?
But
oh, I didn't watch it.
They
anything from you? I...
On the radio, they'll go.
It was a Chuck Norris commercial.
I was listening the other day. Oh, I saw. I didn't watch
I've
it.
I've seen that
I,
before, though.
On the radio, they're like, "Oh, Anheuser-Busch is known for
this,"
and I'm like. Change the station. I don't even want to.
Yeah.
I don't want the spoilers.
Yeah, but
I want to see it.
Our hatred for AB runs pretty deep. So.
Well, I mean, still,
we have
I
hatred.
Just,
like,
I don't have
like,
hatred.
I don't like them.
I had a nice Michelob Golden over the weekend.
I Michelob wouldn't say any Golden. Of that beer is nice. Yeah.
It was refreshing. It was light and refreshing.
All right.
You were looking up bets and stuff.
Yeah. What were you? Go to. You bet on the Super Bowl?
I never have. Greg used to do squares and stuff like that.
Yeah,
I,
the squares are pretty easy. That's actually pretty dumb luck.
Right.
Yeah.
That's fun, though. I don't mind doing
it. I found some of the strange bets. Keep going down.
It's not like this isn't going to start yelling at me, this tab, is it?
I don't think so.
Coin toss.
Coin toss, it's 105, negative 105 to negative 105. So
it's pretty 50. Well, obviously, that's a 50-50 bet right there.
Yeah.
Team to win.
Keep going down. There's some funny ones about the national. Will the national anthem last longer than a minute and 58 seconds?
Yeah.
Will Luke Bryan be wearing what? What will Luke Bryan be wearing when he what? When he starts singing the national
anthem? I'm assuming he'll have blue jeans on.
Yeah, I would imagine.
Will he be what? Will Luke Bryan be wearing a hat when he appears on screen?
He's not gonna omit. Words from the national anthem. That's a stupid bet.
Yeah. Halftime show. Which song will Lady Gaga sing first?
What's the favorite?
So,
Born This Way, bad
favorite.
Edge of Glory. Well, which?
Negative. Negative's a favorite.
Oh, so.
Any other song is favorite.
Or Born This Way.
Right? Isn't that right?
We'll look here.
I don't really know how to bet the line like this. I've never done that. I guess we should have looked that up before the show.
Yeah, we're not good at this.
No.
But yeah, there is tons of bets. I'm sure if you're out in Vegas, you can place a lot of different bets.
Can you place these obscure bets online?
The betting online is illegal, isn't it?
Oh, it is. Oh.
Isn't it?
That is illegal, sir. I don't know.
Well, how do you do it then if you're...
Go to a sports book and at one of the casinos.
So we're going to your house for a big Super Bowl party.
I wouldn't say big, but yeah.
Oh, it's going to be huge, right?
Well, actually, I found out today. Apparently, Jackson's inviting a bunch of people from school that we didn't know. So this ought to be entertaining. See a bunch of kids show up.
Yeah. Well.
But are we going to play some interesting bets at your little shindig?
Wasn't planning
like how
it.
Early he throws us out before the game's over.
He'll go.
All right,
it's bedtime.
It's time for bed.
All right. Well, it's been fun.
Halftime, right?
Yeah. We appreciate you coming over, but I got to get to bed.
Right in the middle of halftime.
I know Gaga's
still playing.
Turn
the TV off. Yeah.
He turns
the head.
Get out.
It's been fun.
Oh man. Well. Do you want to, while we're on Super Bowl, you want to do a beer?
Sure.
All right.
What do you got?
Well,
amongst yourselves.
Yeah, he's leaving the studio again.
We've done this a couple times where we try to pick a beer from a city.
It's tradition.
The cities. Yeah. You know, one thing we haven't done is tried to find beer from the city that's hosting the Super Bowl. We always go with the teams.
Houston.
Yeah, it's Houston this year.
Yeah. Oh,
well.
I don't know what they would have down there.
So, I'm sure they have beer.
Oh, these are just left in your fridge, aren't they?
Yeah, they're probably a year old.
The one is from last year's Super Bowl.
Okay, hold on, man.
Oh, okay.
We need new glasses.
All right. What is that? It's a dogfish head, right?
Dogfish head.
And it is...
Pumpkin ale.
Oh, pumpkin. Yeah. Pumpkin. I thought it was called pumpkin chunk.
Nerd alert. Pseudo Pilsner. Monday Night Brewing Company.
Okay, here's the thing. Finding a... Well, New England, there's a big range, and I think we've done Dogfish Head before. It's really not New England. That's Baltimore.
It's Maine, right? Where Dogfish Head is.
Baltimore.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
No. No.
Or it's
or Delaware.
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 Milton, Delaware. This is the closest I can find without getting an actual Sam Adams, you know?
Yeah, and Dogfish Head makes good beer. I mean, they've got really good beer.
So
it is hard to find here in St. Louis,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
You got to cross the river to Illinois to find a Dogfish Head.
Yeah, that's so strange that they don't cross the river.
I mean, yeah.
I guess just different
distribution rights, yeah.
Yeah.
So,
that's Greg's favorite beer. Never mind.
I don't know if you said this, but the Monday Night Brewing, they're from Atlanta, Georgia.
Yingling.
Oh, yeah, that's great.
Atlanta, Georgia. We have one right here called Nerd Alert.
Yeah.
So, we want to do Atlanta first, or we want to do...
So, what's at stake here?
Well, I guess whichever we like best.
Championship
is the winner.
Is the winner.
We'll write him a letter.
Who we predict to be the winner based
on
our tastes.
Oh, God, no.
I'm pretty sure.
Actually, I should get six glasses. Here, why don't you open this?
I'm pretty confident we're probably all going to like the Atlanta beer.
Yeah.
That pumpkin beer from Dogfish Head is really one of the first pumpkin beers, I think, that was around. Isn't that right, Greg? One of the first pumpkin beers to be brewed was through Dogfish Head?
I don't know if it may be one of the first, but it's one of the most popular.
Well, the guy who started Dogfish Head, what's his name?
Sam Colon.
Coke? Is it Coke?
That's Greg Coke from Stone.
Well, I think he only brewed the pumpkin beer, and then he started his brewery after that. Part of that pumpkin chunkin' competition?
Competition? Shooting, yeah, put shooting pumpkins.
His first beer... I actually read his book.
Is that the page you stole from?
His first beer was a cherry wheat. So, we've got the Nerd Alert versus the Pumpkin Ale.
What are we drinking first?
I've already been sipping on the Nerd Alert.
Nerd Alert. Tell me about that. What is that?
Pseudo Pilsner from Monday Night Brewing. Says weekends are overrated.
Pretty good. That has a good beer.
It's smooth. Got a hoppy back end, doesn't it?
Yeah. Smooth, clean, Pilsner-y ale.
Very light, sweet. And like you said, it's got a little bit of a hop to it. Little
probably
ting on the tongue. Is that a thing?
Ting on the
mid
tongue.
Mid to low 30 IBUs.
22.
All right, that's our Atlanta offering. And our... New England, although it's the closest we found in my fridge, is the Dogfish pumpkin ale.
Nope.
So you don't like pumpkin beer, so it's kind of no fair.
I don't think it's terrible. It's got a lot of spice to it.
Really? All I taste is pumpkin in that.
Pumpkin doesn't really have a flavor.
It's more the
spiciness.
I don't get like any allspice out of it or cinnamon
kind of
or
nutmeg maybe.
Maybe a little. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't even know if
I almost get ginger.
Yeah.
All right, let's spice the show back up, Greg. We got any food?
Well, we do.
Hit that button.
got. You should have seen his flair for
Yeah, you didn't see my flair.
I didn't see it. Well, you were about ready to tip that glass over. Oh,
I know.
Oh, shh.
So I got some more crap from Lolly and Pops.
No, no.
But this store, I... where the heck is my new other camera?
This is the place that had the crazy spicy... man, that's weird seeing your shirt twice like that.
It was the...
Jalapeno gummy.
Yeah.
So I thought these are pretty neat.
Is this real?
These are chocolates.
It's like bottle caps.
Those do look cool. Huh. Are you getting like wedding favors from these people or something? How come you're giving them so much free press?
I don't know.
They should be paying for this time on the show.
So
they're beers? Is that Rogue?
So here, let me just.
Are they edible bottle caps?
Yeah, this is all edible chocolate.
Wow.
You sure about that?
So, yes.
You can break a tooth?
So. Here's one from Deschutes. That's the Black Butte.
Cool.
There's,
is it made with their beer?
Yeah, the Rogue.
I don't think you... I think that's a real bottle cap.
It's. Is it... No, it's not.
Huh. Man, it looks real.
There's Rogue. I'll have to get the...
Man, those
There's
look
Widmore.
Real.
And there's Full... Widmore, and then we have Full Sail.
I guess after looking at them up close, like that just shoots one. Look at that. That looks like a real bottle cap.
Yeah, it sure does.
So
they look like they're molded inside of a bottle cap.
Could be. I mean, it, the way they got it painted and everything, it looks real.
So these are like their craft beer truffles, basically. And it's going to be kind of... difficult. Normally you would
to cut them.
Yeah, I'm gonna try and just cut these
for single serving.
So we'd all
That's my four.
Yeah. Where's you guys's?
Yeah. I took a picture of the actual sign.
Hey, okay. You might want to get your I don't want to see your
hand. I'm sorry. Is that it? Okay.
Did you have a clear favorite beer here, Josh?
Oh, by far the Pilsner.
I think so too.
Head and shoulders.
So why don't we start with this Widmer Hefeweizen? It's a beer infused truffle, sharp finish.
So they know you by name
dark
now.
Chocolate.
Place? You've been there so often.
No, Molly went there the last time. So I'm gonna cut this.
Oh God, he's gonna cut his finger off.
Yeah, we're gonna end up going to the hospital.
See, the cap is not.
How are you gonna cut it three ways?
Yeah,
that's. Ooh, that looks delicious.
Oh,
ruin my dinner.
Ruin your dinner? It's a little truffle. Okay. There, have a piece of that Hefeweizen one.
Hefeweizen from where?
The Widmer. I think these are all. These Oregon beers. So you can see the cap actually is not real.
Hmm.
Very crunchy.
I get a little bit of Hef. That's a weird combination.
It is, yeah.
I don't know that. I mean, that's. It's fine because it's chocolate, but.
It's not.
I don't know that.
It's almost like dry or something. I don't know.
Yeah, you have
like,
two totally different flavors there. Chocolate and Hefeweizen.
Weird. It's good.
It's chocolate.
Yeah. Why your dogs keep going nuts up there?
Probably Molly's home
Let's
or
bring
something.
Bring your dog to studio. Now.
Bring your dog. Yeah.
Squirrel.
Yeah, I forgot Sparky's coming over. That's what Jeff was talking about.
That was a great
Sparky's
call.
Our favorite
Tell
dog.
Jeff we appreciate his call.
That was awesome. Fun.
Okay, so our next here is Rogue Ale. Hazelnut brown nectar beer infused truffle roasted hazelnuts malty finish milk chocolate.
That's gonna be good.
Sounds good.
Anything with hazelnut beer or hazelnut coffee, hazelnut chocolate, anything with hazelnuts is good. I don't see three pieces here. What's
There's
wrong?
Two here. I'll have one of the smaller ones. That's fine.
Okay. He said take the whole thing.
Yeah, that's what I heard. You didn't really cut these.
Well,
kinda.
Here, you know what? If I'm gonna explain
your fingers
them, someone else.
Holy crap, that's good.
Here. I can't get them apart here.
Those are good.
So,
wow. So what else are we talking about today? Well, Josh is cutting all these up.
Oh, I am.
Well, he handed you the.
Oh, yeah.
He like gave up. He said, "Here, do this."
Hmm.
Ooh, that is good.
That's really
well,
good.
Let me try that one.
No. That's like a...
Oh! What the...
Jeez, Greg, come on now. Got really excited about
it. I know I did.
Tackle you for that piece. He thought I was going to throw it away something.
Or eat it.
He was afraid I was going to eat it.
Oh, that's good.
That's good. That's a good... Yeah, that's here. You need a napkin, Josh. What else are we talking about,
Last
Greg?
We have... Next we have Deschutes.
Deschutes Black Butte.
Mm-hmm. God, I'm afraid I'm going to cut my finger off here.
Yeah, that's probably Greg's idea.
Oh! Milk chocolate, dark chocolate, roasted finish. So we all like the Black Butte beer.
There's your part. It's all that.
It's like it's...
Jeez. The Black Butte is a great beer.
That is a really good beer. But that roasted hazelnut one that we just had was really awesome.
Mmm.
I know this is good radio. I got to eat it off the knife.
I think this one's better. That's really good.
Black Butte.
That's Black Butte. Yeah, that's good.
Hmm. That is good. What else did we have to talk about?
I don't know, but I'm sure our listeners don't care.
I'm sorry.
So you guys didn't hear the news about Johnny Depp?
We were talking about it before the show. Apparently you have posters of him in your room.
Oh, yeah. I'm a huge Johnny Depp fan. I just thought it was hilarious that he had filed a lawsuit against his financial management team because he said that they were not managing his money well enough and they were taking out loans or spending it without his permission. But the amount that they were spending was all approved by him. It was basically him saying, well, I'm going to buy this, I'm going to spend this, and everything else. So they said that his monthly spending is $2 million a month. That's the average.
That's crazy.
I don't know how you spend that much.
I don't either. I mean, you would have to try really hard to do that.
Well, and some of the things, I mean, the one story they were talking about, and this goes back years ago, I can't remember the author's name, but some author was a friend of his, and he had died, and he took his ashes and, like, blew them out of this. He had this cannon made that he could blow the ashes out of. And then the whole project cost over $3 million.
Holy crap.
And
I'll hook it to a leaf blower for $3 million.
This is an IPA.
So I just thought it was funny because they're now countersuing him, saying that he's basically just an a-hole and constantly yelling at this team of individuals, saying that anytime they would go to him and say, hey, you need to cut back, he'd just like, I can just picture it too, because they said he spent $30,000 a month on wine. I can see him just being like drunk and angry all the time.
Make it happen,
you know. Just what a jerk.
$2 million a month in expenses. How do you do that?
I don't know. They have 14 residents.
Well, homes. Sure, you can't live with less than three. I mean, come on.
I know.
Wow,
that's
amazing.
I mean, that's how the other half lives, guys.
I guess I don't know if I'll ever be there.
More money, more problems. You know.
So I don't know. You tried that IPA one.
That's what that last one was. IPA.
Yeah. I think that'd be better if it was more an orangey flavor than.
But you can. That was the first one that you could actually taste the beer. I think
you could taste the Hefeweizen.
Yeah. This one, I think you really tasted the IPA.
I agree.
Anyway, my pick for this Super Bowl beer, you want to go back to.
Yeah.
I think Atlanta's going to do it. They're really pulling ahead on this one.
You think Atlanta's going
to
beat New England?
Well, according to the beer.
I would be happy to see Atlanta beat New England, but I don't see it happening.
I just think this beer is better. This Atlanta beer.
What's pumpkin wrong? Is hard to drink.
Yeah, it's not good. Hmm. And it could be because it probably sat in his fridge for 3 years.
No, this pumpkin lasts a long time.
Is it from this past October?
No,
really?
No, it's two October. No.
Oh my God.
No, it wasn't. So... 15? A year, a little over a year.
From 15?
Yeah.
Still. And they probably brew it in probably like June.
Probably. To get it canned, to get it bottled and everything.
Well, the Madden 2017 prediction says Patriots win 27-24.
Yeah.
So, really?
Yeah.
Good old Madden.
Good old Madden.
He's still alive?
I think so.
He is, but he doesn't do anything anymore.
He doesn't even do the voiceover on that game. Really? He hasn't done it in like 10 years.
Really? Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Remember them saying that he wouldn't fly?
Yeah.
That he takes buses everywhere.
He'd take a bus everywhere, yeah.
Madden-mobile.
Yeah. Interesting guy.
So, did you hear the Namco founder pass away?
Yeah.
The father of Pac-Man.
Oh, yeah.
91 years old.
Wow.
Masaya Nakamura.
Don't try.
Mr. Nakamura. He's famous for Galaxian, Pac-Man, Galaga, Miss Pac-Man, Dig Dug.
Did you go back and play some of those games in honor of him today?
I did not because he died a few days ago. All those classic games. Galaga is probably my favorite stand-up arcade game, like that era.
You have to stand up when you play it?
You know, the stand-up cabinets.
Oh, I gotcha. Are those all on the NES Classic that came out this year, you know?
I don't think so, because a lot of those probably came on the Atari.
Yeah. I see you have on the agenda the Sad Dog movie. Did you go and protest the bad dog treatment, or did you go pay?
Well, okay.
And violate PETA's protest?
Well, do you want to get to this? I mean, we're jumping around.
It's all right.
I was just going to say stuff I've been watching. Well, what I've been watching. So we went and saw the dog movie, A Dog's Purpose.
Oh, yeah.
So,
did you cry your eyes out?
It's a really sad movie.
It's horrible. The dog dies every 15 minutes, doesn't he?
Something like that. It's pretty... I mean, you guys have both seen Old Yeller, right?
Nope.
But you remember as a kid, him dying at the end. Spoiler alert! Okay. It's kind of the same. I mean, you see the dog dying, and it's like, this is horrible.
How many times did the dog die in the movie?
I think it went through like about five,
That's
six
awful.
Times. Yeah.
There's no purpose for that movie other than
dog's
to make
purpose.
You cry. That's horrible.
It was.
I
don't
Molly
understand.
Is
this
mush
a?
Oh yeah,
out of there.
Molly. Was,
I don't understand. This is a like a dog that comes back to life.
So
or
what happens?
Reincarnation is the big premise of the movie. Oh,
so basically, the dog has his little life as this breed. Then he dies. Something happens
in the first 5 minutes of the movie.
He dies, and then all of a sudden his eyes open, you see he's a little puppy again, but he's a new breed, you know.
And is it a cartoon movie or
no?
Total?
it's
oh, okay,
yeah, it's real dogs and all that.
They,
and
they killed like 15 of them.
Wow, really? Wow.
They did not kill any dog. So PETA was really upset about this movie because
they killed 15 dogs.
They didn't kill any dogs. Apparently, they saw there's video of the dog being thrown in the water.
Oh, I did hear about that a while
on Facebook,
back.
Where all the hate is.
I mean, you know, if you throw a dog in a water, you know, he's going to look like, what? What? Any dog you take and put in a bathtub,
especially
he's gonna have
swirling water like that water,
he's
going to
have the same effect, you know, and from what it was, is. He's used to going into the water from the left. He was trained that way, and he was going in the right way or something.
I get upset when I enter the wrong side of my office.
Probably. That sounds like something you would.
Yeah.
But anyway, it is a good movie, but you're going to cry. I mean, if you have any heart or soul at all.
I don't want to see a movie that makes you cry like that. That's stupid. I'm sorry. That's stupid.
Well, okay.
Do we have any input from our listeners?
So
I'm sure Molly not enjoyed the movie, but
she read the book and she said
was there
she,
a book too?
Yeah, she said she cried through the book. So
she knew what she was getting into.
Yeah.
Yeah, I heard that. I heard a review of it last week where they were talking about the dog dying every 15 minutes. Like, no, I'm not going to see that.
So I saw that movie. I've been watching this show on Hulu, but it's an FXX show called Man Seeking Woman. I don't know if you know the guy from Did you ever see that She's Out of My League?
Yeah, yeah.
Jay Baruchel?
Yep.
Or?
Yep.
Is it a lot of Seth Rogen movies,
He's pretty
too?
Funny.
This show, I've never... It's probably... I think it's on its third season, and I just kind of start... I'm like, eh, what's this? And it's bizarre. So it's kind of like a guy down on his luck. He's kind of a loser. And he keeps getting in these situations where he... To date this girl, like... Several different... Each episode is like a different kind of... He's dating a different girl or a different situation. But it's so over the top. There's like fantasy involved. Like, he went to a wedding that was literally in hell. They like had to go to the center of the earth and climbing down. And like there were demons and stuff on the dance floor. And there was an episode... where they take these pills to go back in time to fix his relationship, and
yeah, I wouldn't watch that.
It's really over the top, but
all right.
I don't know. I've been liking
it. Stay away from that one.
Oh. Kind of. So it's kind of like what was the show on FX where it was Elijah Wood and his dog would talk to him.
See, I didn't like that. I didn't like that.
That Wilford. Sounds exactly like yes, Wilford. It sounds just like this, where it was that alternate reality kind of weirdness.
This, I didn't like that show. I don't know. I like this one.
I think Jay, whatever his name is, he's a pretty funny guy.
But I've been doing that, and I've been watching these, you know, NES. Remember the Nintendo?
Yeah, my kids got me on these. Is this where it's just like it's filmed, and then you see how quickly they can get through?
So, like, Super Mario Brothers.
Yeah.
I don't know why this stuck with me. I'm watching this. This video, and it's basically a guy talking about how fast someone could get through Super Mario Brothers, and someone did it in like 5 minutes and 10 seconds, and then they found this little glitch where if they do this certain thing and go down a pipe, they don't go up the vine, and they'll be able to save like so many seconds, and then they got it down to 5 minutes, and
I think
the record now is 4 minutes and 56 seconds.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
But it's kind of interesting how fast these guys can do it. Because you got to be perfect.
Right.
You can't screw up at all.
Along the same vein of this, it may have been a year or two ago, I stumbled across YouTube videos of people playing Mike Tyson's Punch-Out blindfolded.
Oh, no, I haven't seen that.
And whipping every character and beating the game.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I remember hearing about that because they, like, memorized the moves.
The sound.
Synchronized
it. Counted, like, how many seconds after the rare sound that he goes in and for his... amazing to watch. Like, this guy's wearing a blindfold. Yeah. That's probably all fake because there's probably a third guy playing the game.
Well, I know Mike Tyson, I'm able to beat one guy because all you do is keep mashing on the B button and then he's just boom, boom,
yeah,
boom,
but these guys are like moving left and right and bouncing. Yeah, yeah,
I can't do all that.
But blindfolded.
Yeah. Man. Yeah,
it's Daredevil stuff.
Yeah, I know. Well, Daredevil can kind of see.
With sound.
Yeah. But you guys watch anything interesting?
Man, I have not.
No.
You acted like you were going to say
something. No, I saw another agenda item.
Miss Universe?
No, not Miss Universe.
No, I haven't. I don't think I've watched anything.
We watch Big Bang reruns in our house. That's really all we watch.
Hostess Makes Ice Cream?
Yeah, that's what I was pointing at. How'd you know?
Did you see these?
No.
I'm excited about this.
We'll have to get these for the show, right?
We have to get these. If Hostess or a distributor for Hostess or Schnucks or Deerbergs is listening to us,
they do all the time.
Yeah, yeah. Right. Well, yeah, I'm surprised they haven't called in. But we would gladly give you advertising time if you provided us one of these six or eight.
So it looks like they got tubs of ice cream, like a Twinkie flavor, Snowballs flavor, and a Cupcakes flavor.
I bet you they're the Ben and Jerry size. Pint size.
Probably. And then they have, like, ice cream bars, like a Snowball ice cream bar. And then they have Ding Dongs that kind of look like
an ice cream sandwich. What,
or Chipwich really type of, yeah.
Yeah, I'd eat those.
And then the Twinkies cone kind of looks, it basically looks like a drumstick.
Twinkies makes two appearances.
Is that a ho-ho? That's bottom
a cupcake.
Left.
Cupcake and then a ding dong.
Man, I'd eat the crap out of that bottom left one.
That's kind of interesting that Twinkies makes two appearances there.
Yeah, that is interesting.
Because it's just a yellow, it's a yellow cake. There's not...
Hell, 3 years ago we were talking that they weren't going to exist anymore, right?
Snowballs has two appearances too.
Yeah. Oh, I don't care for Snowballs.
Know, yeah, I never
did. I don't either. I don't really like marshmallow
me
treats.
Yeah. Me either.
Unless it's a crispy treat.
Now, the Twinkie one, depending on how the Twinkie ice cream is, that'd be another... I'd eat that whole tub in a sitting. I mean, seriously.
One sitting, one tub.
I could do it. They're single serving size.
Sitting.
One guy, one tub.
One episode of Big Bang Theory, me on the couch, it's gone.
Oh, man.
Yep, probably in my underwear, yeah.
Why you gotta be in your underwear?
You paint a pretty picture.
I paint a descriptive picture is what I paint.
Is that why you're showing us your new camera in your house? You're like, he's gonna check this out.
No,
look at
test. I'm going to put it outside on the front.
He's going to send us a link. Hey. Eating the ice cream.
Want anybody want to watch? I found that's going to be our Patreon. Me, people can watch me eat ice cream.
Found the hostess Twinkie
in his underwear. Yeah, that's
there'll be people
great.
Lining up for weeks, man.
I don't know if people will pay for that, but maybe
someone would.
Well, wow, that's an idea, I guess.
Weird news, show went girl. Off the rails. Girl with a snake in her earlobe?
Oh, I saw that today.
I didn't see this.
So
this is stupid.
This girl, she
has those gauge earrings.
Yeah, you know where you have the big old...
Oh, that's stupid.
It's about the size of an Oreo cookie, I guess.
I don't know that it's that big.
That's like a baby python or something.
She has, like, I guess... She's playing with her snake and...
Ba-dum-bum.
Well, it decided to go in her earlobe, and it stuck.
You know, when you have that, when you have those types of body art, whatever,
you don't
you
let your
it,
snake crawl through that hole.
You're asking for problems. I'm sorry, but if you put a baby python around your neck and you don't have your gauge in your ear, I'm sorry, you're an idiot.
Yeah,
I never had a snake or the earlobe
thing. I'm surprised
you
don't have the earlobe things.
What? Why? I don't have a tattoo.
Yeah, that surprises me too.
I am...
In your skater days, I could have... If you were Skater Greg now, I could see you having an ear gauge.
Like, back in the day, I had my hair different colors.
And cornrows.
He was punk
rock
Greg.
No, it wasn't cornrows. It was braids.
Punk rock Greg, never Skater Greg.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, I couldn't skate.
Couldn't skate.
Sorry.
I appreciated the skateboard kids, but I could never skate. And I didn't want tattoos because they're expensive.
They are expensive.
And I was like, I know it's punk rock not to have tattoos because everyone's getting them.
There you go.
That's right.
So cool.
Yeah.
Hey, did you guys go to your 20-year class reunion?
Nope. Oh, actually, ours got canceled.
Oh, really?
So I don't remember, was it? There was like two. There was a Friday night one and there was one at the Cardinal game and one at Villa Antonia, I thought.
Yeah, that's right. One of them might have.
We planned ours. I had a meeting last week to start the planning process.
Because you were class president?
I was class president.
There's like 20 people in your
class.
There
were 78. Thank you. Mike was one of them.
Ours was like 780.
Yeah.
And we are having it at Maida Mill.
Wow.
Jenny has agreed to host us upstairs on the Saturday afternoon.
Yeah, they couldn't fit our class.
No. And that was part of my rationale was the last two that we've had, we've only had like 40 people show up. So it's not worth getting a full-blown like reception hall and catered food because it ended up being like $80 a person because it'd be so few people.
So what are you like renting out the top floor or whatever?
Yeah, Denny put me on the book to be upstairs, and we're gonna, you know, everybody buy their own beer, their own food, kind of thing, and we're gonna have
that
a band.
Really fun.
Dandelions. I think we're gonna have the Dandelions play because he was in our class.
He's one of the
Mike was in our class. So yeah, well, 20 years makes me freaking feel old.
Man, I'm not even there yet.
Shut up! You're like 6 years older than me.
Six years, man. I haven't been...
It was last year.
I thought you guys were 2 years ahead of me.
Okay, 95.
You graduated 95?
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, 2 years. Yeah, 2 years ahead of me.
He says it like he's one of our kids. Oh, my God. Back in the 90s?
No, yeah. We were at the end. You were at the beginning.
Yeah. 95 is not the beginning.
I know.
It's like saying I'm in my... It's
like, hey, it's, back
well,
in
you
the
turned
day.
40 this year,
oh,
right?
Oh, man, like 2 weeks from today.
Oh,
no, 2 weeks from yesterday.
Yikes.
I'm less than 2 weeks away.
So are you using Viagra yet? Has that been a problem?
No.
Have you had your prostate checked?
I think that you don't have to do that until you're 50 now.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I think what happened was the guy who makes those recommendations, like, oh, yeah, by the time you're 40, you need to get that. Like, all of a sudden,
he turned 40.
He's like, I mean 50. By the time you turn 50.
Because colonoscopy is 52, isn't it? Or 50 also. As well. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, they changed it to 50.
And see, I've got a history. My family has a history of.
Oh, so you've already got yours.
No, but I have to start early, I think.
Lady I work with, her husband just went through the colonoscopy thing. And you go, I guess you go under and everything.
Yeah.
And
well, you don't. I mean, they give you propofol. It's conscious sedation.
Oh, is it? Well, yeah. He was like, she said he was like really loopy when he came out of it.
That's
one of those situations where it's just funny, you know, talking. To
exactly.
Somebody.
If any
can
one
we
of
go?
Us
go, go, can
yeah.
we go
it's
and video
it's not until I'm 50.
Yeah. If well, any one of us we'll ever go have to go under or something for surgery or whatever, we got to record it.
That's like
the whole waking up,
yeah,
and asking questions. You know, like seeing what you answer. And
we'll be on like show 500 by then.
Yeah, 500.
Hey, Greg, where can you find us?
Hey, you can subscribe on iTunes, Google Play, or Stitcher. Just search for Stuck in Beta. Also, go to beer30.tv.
Hey, Josh is closing his laptop
to find out more.
We're out of here.
Information.
Give us feedback. Send us an email.
Send us an email. StuckinBetaPodcast@gmail.com.
And if you want to give us ice cream, we'll eat it on the show.
I know that's exciting to watch.
I'm telling
you, if someone has a fetish of watching other people watch ice cream,
yeah, that's weird. But that hostess ice cream would be worth it.
Oh yeah,
I'd eat that. Yeah.
Now, by the time we get it, are we going to be like, well, this is just soup? You know?
No, idiot. We'd go local and buy it.
Well, if someone shipped it to us.
Yeah, whatever. Okay. All right.
Okay,
show.
This has been Stuck in Beta. We'll see you next time.